Did you know that diabetes doesn't just affect your blood sugars? It can also have a huge impact on your muscles, joints, and tendons. So if you're living with diabetes or know someone who is, then this video is for you because I'm going to explore how diabetes can affect the musculoskeletal system from stiff joints and sore tendons to conditions like frozen shoulder, trigger finger, and even arthritis. I'll also cover what diabetes is, how it's managed, and why having good blood sugar control is the key to keeping your body healthy and moving well. I'm Stephen Bunting, and I'm a specialist MSK physiotherapist working in the UK. Welcome to my channel, where you won't find any clickbait or false promises. As one of my subscribers said, this information is like real nutrition, not just fast food. Diabetes is a condition where the body either doesn't produce enough insulin or can't use it properly. Insulin is a hormone made in the pancreas, and it stimulates your body to absorb glucose or sugar from the bloodstream and move it into your cells where it's used for energy, almost like a battery for the cells. When this process isn't working properly, glucose can build up in the bloodstream, and it's those high glucose levels that can cause problems in many different tissues throughout the body. There are two main types of diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is usually diagnosed in children and younger adults. It's an autoimmune condition where the body's immune system attacks the insulin-producing cells in the pancreas for reasons that we don't fully understand. People with type 1 diabetes will control their blood sugars by administering insulin, either by injection or by an insulin pump. Now, type 2 diabetes is a very different condition, and it's usually diagnosed in older age and is far more common. It's often linked to genetics, being overweight, and having an unhealthy lifestyle. Type 2 diabetes is often associated with many different side effects and complications, particularly if it's poorly controlled. Indeed, type 2 diabetes is a huge and growing burden on healthcare systems worldwide. In 2022, it was estimated to cost the US economy over $400 billion. There's also pre-diabetes, where the blood sugar levels are raised, but are not yet in the diabetic range, but still potentially high enough to start causing problems. So being pre-diabetic is a warning sign to start making the lifestyle changes that are necessary to prevent you from developing the full-blown condition. Managing diabetes is all about keeping blood sugar levels within a healthy range. So this might involve dietary changes, so reducing sugary and processed foods, exercise, so basically using up the body's glucose supplies, weight management. By reducing body weight, this can really improve insulin sensitivity and potentially lead to type 2 diabetes remission. Medications like metformin. Insulin therapy for those who need it, which is all of the type 1 diabetics and the type 2s who are struggling to get control with the other methods. To measure how well diabetes is controlled, we use a few different tests. Fasting glucose, which is your blood sugar level after not eating overnight. Daily glucose monitoring, so using a finger prick test or a continuous glucose monitor. And HbA1c, which is a blood test that shows your average glucose levels over the past 3 months. This is the most useful of the tests to check your overall diabetic control. An HbA1c of 48 or above typically indicates diabetes, and the goal for most diabetics is to keep it under 53. Levels which consistently exceed 75 are strongly associated with many different side effects and complications, many of which are caused by damage to the blood vessels, which we call peripheral vascular disease. So this can cause an increased risk of stroke and heart failure, and basically an increased risk of early death. And also damage to the nerves and the small vessels in the eyes, kidneys and limbs, which can lead to kidney failure, loss of eyesight, and potentially loss of limbs. Having poor circulation can also lead to higher rates of infection and poor healing response. So basically, lots of very bad things can happen to people who have long-term badly controlled diabetes, which is why it's such a costly problem to healthcare. When blood glucose levels are too high for too long, it can affect many different tissues throughout the body, and that includes the muscles, tendons, joints, ligaments, and nerves. High blood sugar levels can lead to general inflammation, damage to small blood vessels that supply your tissues. It can affect collagen, which is the protein that gives structure to tendons and ligaments and much of the connective tissue that forms the scaffolding of the musculoskeletal system. It can also slow down healing and recovery, and it can impair nerve function. And the result of this is that diabetes can lead to a much higher risk of MSK problems and cause slower recovery when they do occur or when you have an injury. So let's break down some of the most common musculoskeletal problems that we see in people with diabetes. And first up is frozen shoulder. So this is where you develop a stiff, painful shoulder, often with quite severely restricted movement. It's thought to be about 5 times more common in people with diabetes, and it's caused by poor blood flow, low-grade inflammation, and collagen changes to the capsule of the shoulder. It often takes months or years to resolve, particularly in diabetics. For more information about frozen shoulder, you can click the link up here or see the video description where I've done a much more detailed video. Next up is trigger finger. So this is where a finger gets stuck in a bent position and then suddenly releases like a trigger. It's caused by thickening of the tendon sheath. A single finger can be affected or sometimes multiple fingers, but it's much more common in long-standing diabetes. And again, if you think you might have a trigger finger, then check out this video, which again, I'll link to in the description. Next up is neuropathy. So this is damage to the peripheral nerves, often in the feet or the hands. Symptoms can include a numbness, a tingling, or a burning feeling in the fingers and toes, and sometimes weakness as well, which can affect balance and increase the risk of fall and injuries. It may also contribute to muscle wasting and changes in joint structure. Next up is tendinopathy. Tendons can become painful and weakened in diabetes, especially with overuse. Diabetes alters the tendon structure, reducing strength and increasing injury risk. Common sites are the Achilles tendon, the rotator cuff tendons in the shoulder, and the knee patella tendon. Next is Dupuytren's disease. So this is where you get a thickening of the tissue in the palm, which can sometimes cause the fingers to curl in. This is much more common in people with diabetes, especially type 2. I've also covered Dupuytren's disease in detail, which you can see in this video, which I'll also link to in the description. And then we have osteoarthritis and Charcot joint. Diabetes increases joint inflammation, which can contribute to arthritis. And Charcot arthropathy is a severe complication of diabetic neuropathy where the joint structure breaks down, often in the foot, leading to swelling, deformity, and pain. And then we have general delayed healing, post-injury or post-surgery. Even small injuries can take much longer to heal if blood sugar is poorly controlled. And there's a higher risk of infection, poor scarring, and slower post-operative recovery. So this is why good glucose control is vital before any planned surgery or injury rehab. Okay, well, so far it's been pretty bad news, hasn't it? Well, let's now discuss the good news, because many of these complications can be prevented, treated, or improved by managing your blood sugars. But it's vital that you do take action, or you're going to be fighting a losing battle. People often come to my clinic with various musculoskeletal problems related to poorly controlled diabetes, and I'll tell you what I tell them. There is very little that I can do to help control your pain until you get your blood sugars under control. In fact, many of the conventional treatments that I might usually suggest, such as physio or physical therapy, medications, injections, or even surgery, are often unlikely to help, as their effects are essentially diluted, or just rendered ineffective in the presence of high circulating blood sugars. So, for example, if you have a frozen shoulder and have poorly controlled diabetes, then I'm going to tell you that the single most important treatment that you need to prioritise above anything else is improving your diabetic control. And I can't stress that enough, because otherwise any other treatment like injections or physical therapy is likely to be ineffective. So in a way, it's a simple message and a single treatment. Just put all of your effort into achieving that one goal, improving your diabetic control. So my advice is to work with your doctor or your diabetic nurse to keep your blood sugars within a healthy range. Follow their advice and carefully follow your treatment plan and any medication regimes. Stay active. We know that regular movement helps with glucose control and keeps your joints healthy. So going out for daily walks and getting yourself a bit out of breath through sports and exercise can be really helpful. Maintain a healthy weight. This is vital to reduce pressure on the joints and also improve insulin sensitivity. Check your feet regularly. Feet are particularly vulnerable to the vascular effects of diabetes, and early detection can prevent big problems. So be vigilant and get checked out if you have any signs of infection, such as changes in skin colour, areas of broken skin, heat, pain, and swelling. And don't ignore pain, especially if it's lingering or affecting your movement. Get checked out if a persistent pain isn't improving. See a physical or physiotherapist early for issues like frozen shoulder or tendon pain. Your musculoskeletal system reflects your overall health, and looking after your diabetes means looking after your ability to move, work, and enjoy life. So to summarise, if you're living with diabetes, then remember, staying in control of your blood sugars isn't just about preventing long-term complications like heart disease, stroke, and kidney failure. It's also about protecting your mobility and your quality of life day to day. Okay, well that's about it. If you found the video helpful, then please give it a like and let me know in the comments if you've experienced any of these diabetic MSK issues yourself. And please consider subscribing to get more evidence-based information about your musculoskeletal health. So until the next one, take care and bye for now.